In the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, one God. Come and get close. You guys are way too far away. If I could ask you a question, I'm going to have to walk a mile to get to you. So who knows what happened 41 days ago? No? Christmas. Christmas was 41 days ago. Now, did I count all those days? Do I know that? Nope. I know it because yesterday was the feast of the presentation of Christ to the temple. And how old was he when he got presented to the temple? 40 days, which meant Christmas was 40 days ago. I'm so smart, aren't I? Well, 40 days ago yesterday. 41 today. You keep me on my toes. You're absolutely right. So I want to ask you, don't say it, but raise your hand if you can remember everything you got for Christmas. Parents, grandparents, godparents who were stressing over every little thing. Yeah, hard to remember. And they were so important to me. And now he's saying one more thing. That's good. You can put your hands down. That's what I thought. Can you remember one thing that you got? What did you get? Name one thing you got.
I got an
ornament
for one of the
kids this year. Very nice. Alright, what did you get? A candy cane. Nice. Again, remember the thing that you remember. Yes. A Barbie. Nice. How about over here? What do you guys get? I think number one thing.
Legos.
Legos. Nice.
Star Wars.
Star Wars. There you go. One over here. What is it?
A Slinky.
A Slinky. You noticing, parents? You getting on your knees? A little less stress. That's a different shopping Slinky. So, these things that we think are so important, sometimes we're like, after a while, it's like, yeah, it's not that important. But whose are they? All those toys, who got them? They're yours, right? Did any of you make those toys?
No.
Did you get the money to make them?
No.
They were given to you, right? They were gifts. Now, anybody here have any money? Not necessarily on them now, but just have it.
Yeah.
Those of you in the back, no, Linda doesn't, we know that. I see her making down. She has money. A little less.
Yeah.
Some of you have money. Now, is that yours?
Yeah.
On the one hand, it's yours. Did anybody make that money? You might have done some work with this. Somebody gave you the money to pay you. Some of that money you got as gifts, right? How many of you have money you got as gifts? So we can get money that we earn. We can get money that's given to us. You know, there's another way that we can get money. You know what that is? What? Huh? So that's how you can earn it. It's a big word. Investment. So, Katie, we're going to talk about the stock market today. You can take your money. Whether it's really yours or not, we'll get back to that in a minute. But you can take that money, you give it to someone else, and they take that money to work, and then when you give it back, hopefully you have more money. Does that sound familiar?
Yes.
When did you hear a story like that? Really easy. Like 4 minutes ago. The gospel today was about investment. So a man is going on a journey. They come in here, by the way, a man. It's often really about God. That's how Jesus tells stories. But a man was going on a journey. He took what was his and he entrusted it to the servants. Now, they were talents. They weren't talents like you think of a talent show. It wasn't like one guy could do the palm and one guy could juggle it. Type of money. Very good. A lot of money or a little money?
I don't know.
A lot.
Is it like a bag?
Talent is a lot of money. Big bag. Big bag. And he said, all right, so you, servant number one, I'm going to get dropped. Servant number two, you get two. Servant number three, you get one. Was that fair?
No.
So get over it. Life isn't fair.
No.
So he gave all the money out, but did he just give it away and say, I don't care if I get it back? Why did he give it to the servant? Who knows?
You know.
Say nice and loud. Nice and loud. He wanted to multiply it. He wanted that money and more back. He was investing. He wasn't going to make anything or do anything. He was going on a trip. And he gave that money away to his servants. Go and work with this. And when I come back, I want my money back and the money that you're going to work for when you invest that money and do whatever you do, trading, whatever you do. And he came back, right? The first servant was the five. How many did he bring back to the master? Five and five more. Very good. Second one. How much did he gave him? Two?
Two more.
He came back with four. Very good. That was a good investment. Right? Now the third one, how many did he give him?
One.
And he came back with?
One.
One. He got his money back, which isn't terrible, but did he want just his money back? No, he had invested that money. He wanted us to go out and do some trading or do something with it, make some money with it, and bring back that one and some more. And in the story, Jesus calls that person a wicked servant. What does wicked mean?
Terrible.
Okay? What does this tell us? It tells us a couple of things. First of all, that we all have things that have been given to us. You got your toys. So if you have some money, what else do you have that's been given to you? Clothes.
Family.
Your home. Food. And one big one, time. You have been given time. Yeah. You've been given time. Now the question is, what do we do with it? A lot of what we do, let's be honest, with our time, we do for ourselves. We want to play, we want to have fun. Anything wrong with playing?
No.
Is there anything wrong with all you do is play all the time?
Yeah.
Why? Because we have a master. Who's our master?
God.
And he's saying to us, I'm going to invest in you. And he gives us stuff that really isn't ours. Remember, so we get back to that? Now we're back to it. All the things we have, they're from him. So they're really his, and he loaned them to us. And he says, but I want them back, and I want you to do something really good with them. And is he going to come back? Yeah. You know, in our world today, we can do this with our money. We can invest in things like stocks, right? I did some research. Listen to this. If you bought Apple stock, how many of you have ever seen an iPhone? Who makes iPhones? Apple, okay? If you bought Apple stock when it was selling for $22 a share, the share is a little tiny part of that company. You bought 10 shares for $220 when Apple started. And Apple did some work, or they made some things, and then they came back. How much did you have today with that $220 investment? Take a guess.
$22 million.
A little less. We've had some down. $144,000. If you invested $220 today, it'd be worth $144,000. Someone else got a really good idea. Any of you order, or do your parents ever order stuff online? Yeah. Okay. Somebody had a great idea. They said, what if you could order toys online? Because before they ever could before. They said, let's do an online toy store. Everybody goes, that's a great idea. And somebody said, well, if you can own part of a company, do you want to own it? Oh, yeah, sign me up. And they paid $76 a share for a little tiny part of a company called eToys. Good name, huh? eToys.com. So if you gave your $76, then you bought 10 shares. You bought 10 shares. How much money is that? $760. What if you bought 100 shares?
$7,600.
And you put that money in your own toy, making a bunch of money. Go sell lots of toys around the world online. It didn't work, did it? Guess how much all the money worth today?
$200.
Zero. They went broke. It didn't work. What does it tell us? It tells us there are good investments in this life and bad investments in this life. And there are good investments in the kingdom of heaven and bad investments in the kingdom of heaven. So, do we want to make good investments in the kingdom of heaven or bad investments?
Good.
Good one. So what do you have that God has shared with you? Time.
Toys.
Money.
Toys.
Shelter. And he wants you to invest it well. If all we do is entertain ourselves and play, does that do anything for God?
No.
He wants us to take even just a part of that, the time, the money, whatever we have, and share it and help people. Does that do anything for God?
Yeah.
He sees the people that he loves the most gaining from what you guys do. That's an important thing. It's a really important thing. Today, we are continuing to celebrate a feast that we celebrated yesterday, which was how many days ago?
41.
Yesterday was 41. It was the presentation of Christ. Christ was 40 years old, and his parents took him to the temple, and they presented him to God, because that's what we did that day. We still do it today. Anybody here was ever in church? Or seen a church? Yeah. We get church still. We still do it in remembrance of what happened with Jesus. And there were two people waiting there in the temple. Everybody know their names? Remember? Very good. Simeon and Anna. Were they waiting for a short time or a long time? Anybody believe in superheroes?
Nope.
The saints are real superheroes. Jimmy had a superhuman power. He lived for several hundred years. True story.
Just
as he got. Say it again.
God promised that he would save Jesus, so he lived that long just as he
got. That's right. And that was a long time, which was something God had known for his time. Sinning is a good investment. He said, I'm going to wait and wait and wait because God promised I would never see Jesus. And you know what? Jesus makes the same promise to us. If we work hard, not just on playing is fine for a while, but playing and sharing with other people, taking what's ours, our money and our time, and the talents and gifts that God gives us to use for things that are good, especially for the ones that you love, people that don't have a lot. Then that's a good investment. Would it pay off for Simeon and Anna? They got to see Jesus. What will pay off for us if we do the same thing? Who are we going to get to see? Everybody say it.
Jesus!
Is that worth it?
Yes!
That's a good investment. So I want you to think about your time, think about your money, think about whatever is yours that God loans you, and invest it well. If we invest it poorly, we get nothing. Nothing. If we invest it well, we get to see Jesus and we get to the kingdom of God. Sound good?
Yeah!
So let's invest well. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you all. Y'all go back to your seats.